gentlemen, so by the feeling in the room of positive vibes and the wonderful smell of cocoa butter, it could only be one person sitting in here with me today, and that's Baltimore Blast assistant coach David Bascome. Hi, David.
Shea butter.
It is shea butter.
Yeah, yeah,
I apologize. I took the cocoa butter. It's sort of an island thing. Like, that has to be what they're using. Shea butter. It does smell amazing.
Yeah, that's good though. Yeah. That's good.
And you, I will say, you always look. Your skin always looks very healthy and vibrant. I don't know either. So let me ask you this: how long have you been a professional soccer player?
28 years. Well, let's pull it this. Yeah. Been in the environment for 28 years as a player coach, but best playing 18 years playing.
You played 18 years?
18 years. 18 years.
Wow. And most of us know, but for those that are watching for the first time or learning, you are originally from Bermuda.
Yep.
Which is one of the most beautiful places in the world. And David Bascome, am I saying that correct? Bascome. I apologize.
That's all right.
I wanted to know properly. David Bascome. David, you are very involved back home in Bermuda, although America is your home now.
Yes.
But
yep.
Your original home in Bermuda with soccer and the youth and the culture. So tell us a little bit, as Americans watching this, what is something that Americans can learn from Bermuda?
When you're looking at a small island or country, right?
Sure.
62,000 people. We only have, you've got.
I'm sorry. Football. Did you say your entire country is 62,000?
62,000. Stop it.
No, no. I mean, that's the size of a small town in Baltimore or Maryland.
I'm sure everybody can get into Ravens Stadium. Right?
Yeah. Your whole country.
Yeah. So there's a culture and climate, and when you're so connected, what you find is that. Even with sports, right?
Yeah.
We only had, back in the day, was football, as you call soccer here.
Yeah.
And cricket.
Yeah.
So our greatest game is football.
Yeah.
And our greatest pastime is cricket. So TV, we only had two channels back then. So what you found is that it was a lot of culture-related learning, a lot of young people climbing trees. You know, we didn't have ladder work and all these pieces. So you was embedded and embraced. You know, you're in the island. I mean, we had beach. So we go for a run, and we're doing, we call it a Kilimanjaro. So you're running on a beach, you're running uphill. So it was so much, the climate there was unbelievable to be an athlete.
Yeah.
And we only focused on either football or cricket. So that's the one thing is that I've realized here in the U.S. is that with the youth development of football, soccer, is that getting the young people, when they get up and want to go outside and knock the ball around themselves, that's a norm, right? That's a norm in Bermuda. So you got little munchkins that will start off, I'm talking about four.
Yeah.
They know about, the English Premier League. They know about footballers. And this is a part of their culture being, right? Because we are a British colony.
That's what I was getting ready to say. So Bermuda originally, I guess the word is bounded by Great Britain, England. So their culture really had a huge influence on the island. So why soccer is so huge there, and cricket as well. But what I find more fascinating when I hear you talk off the record about your home is that the pride that each, how do I say it? Is it Bermudian?
Yep, that's it.
Each Bermudian has for their home. And everybody I've ever talked to about that's been to Bermuda just says that it's such a wonderful place to visit. And the Bermudian culture is so beautiful and kind and thoughtful.
Yeah, it's kind of amazing because back in the day, tourists got to Bermuda by the people, how friendly we are. When we go, if it's coming to the U.S., if it's going to the islands, we invite people.
Yeah.
Open door, come in, come down to Bermuda, enjoy yourself. And that was a love that we had for our country. And when people got there, they always want to come back. It's nothing when you're looking at, it's a paradise. You wake up, it's a beautiful place, beautiful people.
I have to ask you, though, I have to stop you right there. Yeah, I believe you're in your early 50s now.
Yes.
Yeah. When you go home, does the beauty ever get taken for granted?
I'll tell you what, now I'm enjoying Bermuda even more. Now I do a lot of work in Bermuda. I go back 1 week of every month.
Yeah.
I enjoy it more because I make sure that I embed myself into, you know, just sitting off, as we call it, the rocks, sitting off the rocks, you know, just relaxing, you know, think about getting lunch and just going down the water side and sitting off. It's so, you know, humbling, relaxing. And everybody that comes around you could be a little, could be somebody walking by, or just, you know, they're either going to shoot you or they're going to say hi to you. Now, this is what I learned when I came to the U.S. is that in Bermuda, we too. Yeah, we honk our horns.
Right,
say, hey,
right,
what's
up? Right.
I went to New York for the first time and listen to me. Yeah. My New Yorkers, I'm telling you, I love it. Love New York. But I thought, and I drove my car there, which I was told not to do.
Right.
So I hear this noise. I'm tuning back. I'm like, this is awesome. Everyone's friendly here, right? I'm like, wow, this is a lot of comedians here, right? So they're tuning. I'm like, ah, yeah, great, tuning. Then I realized, it was like 2 days, and that I actually, they gave me the finger. That's
they're really pissed.
Yeah, they're really pissed off. Because me, I'm trying to find my way, right?
Yeah.
And I'm
you're following the toots.
Following the toots. Good job, right? So, but I mean, that's what you get. Love my country, but I'll tell you what, is that being able to have the ability to be here. When I tell you, Bermuda's very hard sometimes because it's so small. When you go away and come back, there's a progressive mindset, and you become more aggressive. You want to have your mindset becomes a growth mindset.
Oh, sure.
And when it's so small, you find is that we have so much ability down there, outside as well as business, everything, offshore banking, everything.
Yeah.
But when I came here once and went back, I wanted to be here. I wanted to be open. I want to move. I want to, you know, really spread my wings. And that's what America has done for me.
Yeah.
It's been so awesome because now I take these tools and I go back to Bermuda and empower young people.
Yeah. Well, it's beautiful. And, you know, I've always been fascinated, honestly. We joke around a lot with each other and have fun, but I've always had nothing but amazing respect for you and been fascinated with the fact that you didn't leave that place. Spiritually, you go back, you care. Let's enough of the niceties. I have to bring this up. So today is December 30th, and the blast just came off an amazing weekend where we just destroyed Rochester and then fought a war last night against Utica. Yesterday, I mean. So two wins, but the weekend before was horrible. I mean, we went to one Florida team that was falling apart as we spoke. Or as we played, and the other one, I mean, a good team and well owned, but just not a good. What the hell happened that weekend? And what did you and our fearless boss here, Coach Kelly, this is what his head must have looked like last weekend. He's like, what the fuck are you guys doing? This is bullshit. But what did happen in your eyes? Went wrong for that weekend? And then, bam, we're the best-looking team in the league the next weekend.
Here's the – let me put some pieces so we can – and I want to be very clear about this, right?
Yeah.
Some things are bigger than the game, than what we see.
Sure.
From a player's ability, the coach's ability. And that comes being able to trust, trust your ability, trust the process.
Yeah.
And then you've got a climate piece, right?
When
you have all different types of personalities – on a team, you're looking at change. When little things of change comes in time, right? And the reason why we have won many championships is because as leaders, we take accountability and we understand.
David's talking nice about a bunch of bullshit.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Exactly, right? So I'm going on that piece. But here's the thing, is that when you get on the field, we are accountable. We have to make ourselves accountable and responsible. Bad weekend, on all sides. Bad weekend on, players, coaches, a mindset. It was bad. And when you get to that point, you get your licks. But what comes with it, now we're looking at the business, right?
Sure.
What comes with it is when we leave the field as coaches, and I can tell you what's on my mind, job.
Yeah.
What happens to your job? And the one thing is that me and Danny have a high integrity with what we do.
Sure.
And the first thing we have to do is put our hands up as coaches and say, okay, are the pieces that's wrong fixable?
Yeah.
Because that's the key. Are they fixable? Then we look at, okay, we're 6 games in.
Yeah.
Then we look at our timeline of success and objectives. So we have to figure all these pieces out, because when you start to get into that panic mode, you have to trust the players. We have to trust them.
Yeah, of course.
And that's what we do.
Yeah.
And for the next week, after, it was all about trust. You got a bond, getting them empowered.
Well, let me ask you this, and not to get to X's and O's here on the show, but from a fundamental soccer football standpoint, was the team playing badly?
Yes.
Okay.
We did not play well.
Right. It really comes down to that.
That's what it comes down,
doesn't it?
Because when we go back, and when you got young players coming in, that's in our group, we have veterans coming in.
Yeah.
It's very tough, because let's say the veterans and they're not having a good day.
Right.
The young players become more magnified. Then they don't get a chance to grow.
They're almost exposed.
Right.
Yeah.
So when we start connecting the pieces, and it all comes in time.
Yeah.
And what you saw is that what I'm excited about is that sometimes these changes take longer than usual.
Yeah.
And for the players to come around in 5 days later,
just
to make that shift, that says a lot, right?
Yeah.
And that's what, but nothing beats hard work.
Yeah.
Feeling some pain, and that's when success comes, and we missed it.
Well, I tell you, that 2 weekends ago was just horrible to watch. And, you know, I felt for you and Danny. You know, we see each other around the office a lot. We joke around with each other. But when push comes to shove, we have to win soccer matches, or we're all not going to be working here.